After 5 years of intensive work, corrections over corrections, over 3,000 photos, a 3 kilo, that 6 pound book, as never done before in history about Indian fishes. And this is only volume one. Here is a soft cover. And I want to show you just a little bit of this monster book.
I just opened it, this soft cover, and I want to tell you a little bit about it. It is about India. It shows in the back and in the front the country. It shows the colors of the families which are in here. Each family has one color. It has an extensive information and dedication of about 500 different species. Each one marked and described in detail. It has a big portion introduction from Sven Okulander. I have written a preface. I have also written extensively of how to use this book. And chapter one is the history of ornamental fishes of India, which goes back over 200 years with all the first publications. Naturally, in the past, there were no photos. And then my grandfather, who introduced some of the first Indian fishes to the aquarium hobby, there's a big chapter on taxonomy, habitats of Indian inland fishes, how they live, where they live. It shows also some of the destructions, unfortunately, of the habitats. And then it shows the river systems, which I analyzed. And then I write about the collecting and transport, maintenance and prevention of diseases, which is very important, especially for the aquarium hobby. And I have also written a list of all inland fishes recorded in India until 1st of January 2018. And this is the complete list, not only the complete list of all species, but also a list of all common names, scientific and common. And chapter 5 is then the order, family, genus and species. So it starts with the Osteoglossiformis, Notopteridae, and tells you all the species in detail, which are found in India. It goes through Anguilliformis, Moringidae. I have written extensively about Ophistidae. And in addition, then comes the Clupeidae, because they're also found in India. And I have naturally included the Baltoridae, or the hill stream loaches, as some people call them. And they are all the species known from India and some new ones, which still have not been described. Some I discovered, some were discovered by others. And this is extensive. The Mycalidae, which is very broadly found in India. After Nemakalidae, we have also the other families, which is Copididae, which you will see. It has a different color. It's yellow. And not only is each family described in detail, it also shows all the species found in the country and some scientific confusion which is known. And after the Copididae comes the biggest family of all, and this is throughout Asia, and that's the Cyprinidae. was the biggest and the smallest fishes found throughout this family, gigantic and tiny ones. And this is the biggest part of the book, is the immense number of cyprinids, which have amazing colors, some of them, or if you want, most of them. And each one is described into the last detail, with a fin account, with a scale account, with the mouth structure, and so on. This is the biggest family of all. There's a big index of references. I must say that naturally I would not have been able to do such a large, big book if I did not have the help of very important people, as Sven Kullander from Sweden, as so many exporters of ornamental fishes from India, as the chairman of Empedia, Mrs. Lena Nenia, the help of amazing photographers, and especially Beta from India, and also in the past some very good photographers I have always supplied fishes with, the late ones, like Hans Mailand. There is an accumulation of photos which would not been able to find anywhere else in the world except from my archives and from the help of those photographers mentioned. And I have to also say thank you naturally to my wife, who helped me tremendously, to my secretary, who is doing the layout for now 5 years, redoing and redoing it constantly. And this is what I have to say, important, the people who helped me.